The word was, prayer is something that goes into your future before you even get there. Like, just sit on that. Hello, 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 hey. Oh my gosh, hi guys, and welcome. I know it's been a very, very, very long time that I've actually sat in front of a camera. I think the last time I sat in front of a camera was around June, when I, May or June, when I recorded my, how I tore my ACL. Quick plug, if you haven't watched that video, go watch it. Amazing story. I went on a rant about how I tore my ACL and the faithfulness of God through that. But I am here with another video for you all, and wow, like, this video today is, first of all, it's random. Second of all, it is, what would I even call this? It's very random, spontaneous, I rather, because I wasn't even planning on filming today, but I was just led to set up the camera and everything and just go ham. So that's why I am here to film for y'all. I will reduce the volume on this. Yes, so I'm here, back with another video, guys. Let's just jump in. Let's just jump in. Let's go. Let's go. All right, guys. So today's video is more of a testimony. This is something that I was actually led to do, that every 5 videos, I'm gonna come on and share a testimony. 5 is a representation of grace, and so that's what I'm here to do, sharing the grace of God, showing, giving glory and honor to God through the 5 videos, pretty much. And also just sharing a personal testimony, just thanking God for all that he has done. And so that's why this video is rather spontaneous. It's not planned, and I'm not even going to be planning. Most of my videos are not planned. I am just naturally led to speak on topics. And so, yeah, so that's what we're gonna do today. I have my little sticky note here. I didn't write much on it, and I have my Bible here. So yeah, talking about grace, talking about the faithfulness of God, talking about a testimony. I can't even begin to say how grateful I am to be where I am today, actually. I know in March the corona has came. Corona said, haha, you thought. So the COVID-19 put everybody on a hold, put everyone on stop. People were out of jobs, people were unemployed, people were stuck in their homes, quarantined, and it really just brought to light certain things within each and every single one of us. Like, there are things that we actually haven't dealt with personally. We've been running away from, we've just masked it with activities and things that were going on within our lives. And so we haven't actually had the time to just sit down, evaluate our relationships with other people, evaluate ourselves, just check on ourselves. Hey girl, how you doing, girl? We haven't done that in a while. And so COVID has really taught, quarantine has really taught a lot of people many different things, and it has actually taught me personally various things. But one thing that I actually wanted to come on here and to just glorify God and to testify to it, and it is his grace, it is his mercy, it is his faithfulness in my life. God is a God that never fails. He's a God that never disappoints. He's always on time. And I remember going through this virus, going through this period of quarantine and corona and everything, I was just like, I was kind of disappointed in myself, but only because I didn't realize how trashy my prayer life was. I didn't realize how trashy getting into the word was for me personally. And so I really, even this time, I knew this season was, because even before this season started, I knew this was a season of planting, of a season of sowing. And so after realizing that my prayer life wasn't the best, my time in the word wasn't the best, my relationship with God wasn't the best, I invested in this season. I chose to get closer to God. And so that led me to join a 30-day challenge where I where we prayed literally every single day. We were praying, building up our spirit man's, building up ourselves spiritually and growing in the faith. And that's what I want to encourage somebody, that it is not too late. Because yes, you might have spent your corona season or your quarantine season not doing anything, just wasting away, waiting for this thing to pass. But this was actually a season of growing. This is a season, the COVID-19 is still here. We still have to quarantine. We still have to social distance. And so I just want to encourage y'all to get into the word, to just build a relationship and an awesome relationship with God, building yourself more spiritually, like building yourself up, praying more often, incorporating scripture within your day. When you're driving, like let the word of God be playing in your car. When you're washing dishes, when you're reading, when you're even working on school activities, if you're that person that can have just background noise, just get into the word. And that's what I wanted to come in here to encourage y'all and to just share how God has been faithful. Only like get in the word, build yourself spiritually. If it's 30 minutes, waking up early in the morning and just praying. You can never pray enough. And a word that came, during the virus, during the 30-day challenge, it was like, the word was, prayer is something that goes into your future before you even get there. Like, just sit on that. Prayer is something that goes into your future before you even get there. And for me, I pray in tongues. I don't know about anyone else, but personally, I pray in tongues, and that helps me even communicate. That's how I communicate with God. And so building yourself up spiritually in that sense, like building your prayer life, building your tongue life, building yourself up, because you necessarily don't know what you might be praying for before you get there. Praying in tongues, you can be praying for anybody. You can literally be praying for yourself. You can just bask in the presence of God. Oh, basking in the presence of God. I just want to stop right here and just pray. I just want to stop right here and just pray for a second. Heavenly Father, I just want to thank you for today. I just want to thank you for anyone that is watching me right now, whatever they may be doing, whatever they might be doing. I pray that as the word comes forth from me, that may they receive it, and may it be ingrained within their hearts. May it be ingrained within their minds, oh God. That this word, oh God, shall be planted, and may it bear fruit within their lives. That I pray that anything that they might be going through, that your peace and your strength would just come upon them right now in the name of Jesus. Your peace and your strength would just come upon them. That your peace that surpasses all understanding would just bind their hearts, would just bind their minds, would just take captive of it and reassure them that you're still God over their lives, you're still God over their circumstances, that no matter what they're going through, no matter the afflictions, no matter the persecutions, no matter the distress, that the people that are around them, no matter what distress that is going on around them, God, that you will reassure them that you're the God that they can put their trust in if they can't put their trust in anyone else. And so, Lord, I thank you for what you're doing in their lives. Continue to bless them. Continue to nourish them with your strength, with your power, with your word. In the name of Jesus, I pray and I give thanks. Amen. Amen. And so, yeah, so going back to what I was saying, during the 30-day challenge, I had the opportunity of growing, and that really kickstarted my, it helped me to just continue to build on that, to continue to build on my faith, to continue to build on, to build my prayer life, to continue to build up my time in the Word, because we're called, we're ambassadors of Christ, and we have to represent God right. We have to represent Him the right way. And so in able to represent God the right way, you have to be able to be equipped. And God equips you. Just be intentional and see how intentional God is to with you. And so that's why I wanted to come on here, to just share that in this period in time where I thought that I was good spiritually, Corona, getting into quarantine, I realized that I wasn't. And so I dedicated the time to be in the presence of God, to stay rooted in the presence of God, to bask in His glory, to bask in His presence, to keep pushing, to keep pushing in the Word, to keep pushing in prayer, so that I can build myself spiritually, not for anybody else, not for the masses, but for myself, for my relationship with God, to get deeper in Him. And in a season where I felt hopeless, in a season where I felt like I couldn't trust anyone around me, in a season where I felt hopeless, God was my hope. God was the person I was able to put my trust in. And so something that I wanted to tell y'all, if you can do this, write sticky notes or somewhere in your room where you have encouraging words. And some of mine were, you are loved. You don't lose hope. Keep trusting in God. God is your anchor. You are amazing. You are doing great. God is an on-time God. God will never fail you and will never disappoint you. And so surround yourself with the Word. Surround yourself with God, and He will never fail you. And before I go, a word, before I even started this, the word that dropped in me was Psalms 91 verse 1. Whoever dwells in the shelter of the Most High will rest in the shadow of the Almighty. And I just wanted to leave that word with you. I won't go any further, but let me just give you a little thing. So whoever dwells, to live in that place, to dwell in the presence of God is to live in the presence of God. The shelter is a protective place. It's a protective place. The shelter is a place that keeps you safe from harm, that place that shelter, that God shields you. So when you live in the presence of God, when you live in Him, He shelters you. He's your shelter of the Most High, God Himself, and will rest the peace of mind, the peace that transcends, that surpasses all understanding. You will rest in that. You will walk in that. Whoever dwells, whoever lives in a shelter, whoever lives in the protective place of the Most High, will have peace of mind, will find rest for their souls in the shelter, the shadow, the shadow of the Almighty. And I encourage y'all, yeah, and that was the word for even this corona season. But I don't understand, I didn't understand why God wanted to, for wanting me to share that. But I just wanted to share with y'all to bask in the shelter of the Most High, to live in the presence of God. Live in the presence of God. Catherine Coleman said, she was saying this to one pastor in one of her interviews, the last interview she had before she passed on, and she was like, stay in the will of God. Stay in the will of God. In order to stay in the will of God, you have to learn to stay in the presence of God. God is so good. God is so good. And I just feel his presence right now. And I just, oh God, you're so good. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Abba, Father. And so I want you to carry this presence with you to your room, wherever day, time, minute, second, wherever you're watching this at from. Please dwell in the presence of God. Build yourself spiritually. Build yourself up in the spirit and see what God does through you and in your life. And that's all I have for y'all today. Yeah, and so I just want to close with a little prayer for y'all. Dear Heavenly Father, I just want to pray for everyone that is watching me right now. That Father Lord, may you come into their rooms, may you come into wherever they are right now. And may you just take them into your presence. May you wrap them, oh God, take them into your presence, oh God. And may you teach them, oh God, how to live, how to dwell within your presence, how to rest in you, God. That may they carry the shadow of the Almighty with them. May they carry the glory and the presence of God with them, because they've known to live in the presence of God. And so, Lord, I pray this forth for their lives, that whoever needs you right now, that Father, Lord, may you just come into their hearts. May you rest within them, oh God. And may you reassure them that the season that they're going through will not be long lasting. The preparation season may take longer than the manifestation, because the preparation season gets you ready. And so reassure them that this season is the right season that they're in, that they should keep pushing forth your word. They should keep staying in your word. Just give them the strength. Give them the strength to stay in your word, to stay in your presence. And God, may you manifest within their lives. Thank you, Father, for all that you have done within their lives. May they continue with you. May they continue in you. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen, amen, amen. Stay blessed. Thank you for watching. God be with you. God bless you. May he keep you. May he make his face shine upon you. May he be gracious to you. May he turn his face to you and give you peace. Shalom, shalom, shalom. Thank you for watching. If you want to subscribe, like, comment, share, whatever it is you want to do with this video, go ahead. God loves you. He cares for you. He loves you. And stay tuned for my next video. I don't know when. I'm not making any promises. We're led by the Spirit of God. And I will catch you guys later. Bye. Bye, everyone.